Okay students, so in the previous class we had started with null hypothesis and the alternative hypothesis. We had discussed with a few examples, but still we are going to talk about it. So we had started with alternative hypothesis. So alternative hypothesis is the hypothesis which is accepted when this null hypothesis is rejected, isn't it? So for now an example, so we'll take one example here. A company has stated that their straw machine makes straw that are 4 millimeter diameter. Okay, so there is a company which produces straw. Okay, so let's say there is one company which produces straw. And the company says that we produce straw which has a diameter of 4 millimeter. A worker believes that the machine no longer makes straws of this size. And samples now the company says that it makes a straw of size 4 millimeter diameter, but one day one person comes and says, I think now this machine no longer makes straw of this size. So now what we there is a hypothesis here, there is a statement regarding the parameters of the population. What is the population here? Population here is straws, the number of straws that have been produced in the factory. So and the parameter here is the diameter. So we straws of this size and sample of 100 straws to perform a hypothesis test with 99% confidence. So now to prove whether the factory makes straw of 4 millimeter or not, we have to take a sample of 100 straws and we have to check the diameter, and we'll find the whether the diameter is still 4 millimeter or not. So in this case, what will be the null hypothesis? Null hypothesis is denoted by H naught. So we can say that the mean of the straws nu, taken as nu, is 4 millimeter. So this will be our null hypothesis. And there will be another hypothesis denoted by HA, or in our textbook they have denoted it by H1. This is called the alternative hypothesis. The alternative hypothesis will be the nu is not equal to 4 millimeter. So this will be our alternative hypothesis. Now we have a null hypothesis and our alternative hypothesis. We'll conduct a test. We'll take a samples of 100 straws and we'll find out. So basically this example I just wanted to tell you to make clear what is null hypothesis and what is alternative hypothesis. When a real life situation comes, first we have to be clear with how to select which is null and which is alternate. On the basis, only once our selection of the null and alternate becomes correct, then we can go forward for testing. So the definition again we'll go through. Null hypothesis is a hypothesis which is being tested for a possible rejection under the assumption that it is true. Now according to the company assumption that the straws are made of 4 millimeter diameter, but this null hypothesis is been under a test for a possible rejection. It is not sure that the straw will be 4 millimeter or not. After the test is conducted, we'll get to know whether the company is still producing 4 millimeter diameter straws or not. So we have been putting this under the test. So the null hypothesis is the hypothesis which is being tested for a possible rejection under the assumption that it is true. And alternative hypothesis is a hypothesis which is accepted when the null hypothesis is rejected. So now example, if we'll do the testing and we found out that the company doesn't manufacture straws of 4 millimeter. That time this has been rejected and this has been accepted. So we say that the company no longer produces straws of diameter 4 millimeter. Okay. Now for example, if we want to test the null hypothesis that the population has a specified mean nu naught. Say we take some population, it can be anything. We'll take a random population and we say that it has a specified mean nu naught. Okay, so this will be our null hypothesis, saying that this population has a mean nu naught. So what will be our alternative hypothesis? That is H naught will be nu, that is nu naught. Then the alternative hypothesis could be, H1 can be, population mean differs from a specified mean. We can say that the alternative hypothesis can be nu is not equal to nu naught. Or we can say the population mean is less than the specified mean. That is, nu is less than nu naught. Or we can also say H1, the population mean is greater than the specified mean. That is, nu is greater than nu naught. So, now in alternative hypothesis also, we have two-tailed, left-tailed and right-tailed. So, what is this example? Here one population is there. We are saying that the specified mean of this population is nu naught. So, we take the null hypothesis as, this is denoted by nu, right? So, we are saying that the null hypothesis nu is nu naught for this population. This is the null hypothesis. So, what can be the other alternative hypothesis? H1 can be, we can say nu is less than nu naught, or we can also make a statement saying that nu is not equal to nu naught, and another statement we can make saying that nu is greater than nu naught. So there are three possible chances of making an alternative hypothesis. So this is two-tailed hypothesis, this is left-tailed hypothesis, and this is the right-tailed hypothesis. The name comes because of the direction, whatever we are specifying. It is very important to set up the alternative hypothesis, since it enables us to decide whether to use two-tailed test or one-tailed test. Now in this example of the what we took of the factory producing chips, we made the null hypothesis saying that one packet of chip is 200 gram. Okay, so that was, so according to our that example, our H naught was nu naught will be 200 grams. So we can just write nu is 200 grams, and our alternative hypothesis is nu is not equal to 200 grams. That's it. So this is a two-tailed test, two-tailed alternate hypothesis we are taking. If a person had said that no, I think the each packet of chip is less than 200 gram, then what our alternative hypothesis would be? It would be H1 is nu is less than 200 grams. So that is, this will be a left-tailed alternate hypothesis. If it was greater than 200 grams, if we are saying that the each packet of chips is greater than 200 gram, then this would be right-tailed alternative hypothesis. So it is a very important to set up the right alternative hypothesis, since it will make us easier to decide whether, see, once if our alternative hypothesis it is proper, either it is not equal to or it is less than or greater than, then when we do the testing, it will be easier for us to decide whether the alternative hypothesis was correct or the null hypothesis that we had taken is correct. So it is very important to get to know what is null and what is alternative hypothesis. You can see few videos in YouTube regarding the examples. There are so many explanations given. So you all can see it and you all can get a clear idea on what is null and what is alternative hypothesis. We'll see next few topics in the next class. Thank you.